본인의 삶은 천명을 따라 질주해 온 피와 땀과 눈물이 긴 고난의 세월이었습니다.
아버지 너무 고생하셨어요. 아버지 사랑해요.
After 93 years, the true father of heaven, earth, and humankind concluded his earthly life, surrounded by his loved ones' prayers and expressions of farewell.
네, 통일교 창시자인 문선명 총재가
오늘 새벽 향년 92세로
새벽에 별세했습니다.
And from South Korea tonight, news of the Reverend.
헤드라인스 어라운드 더 월드 리포팅 히즈 패싱. 텐즈 오브 사우즌즈 오브 모너스 케임 투 페이 데어 리스펙스. 메모리얼 알터스 아르 이렉티드 인 청평 앤 이븐 인 평양 노스 코리아. 비기닝 인 토키오 재팬 앤 스루아웃 더 월드. 피플 해브 가더드 듀링 더 13 데이즈 오브 더 모닝 피리어드. 굿 피플 인 보스 더 스피리추얼 앤 피지컬 월드스 케임 투 모른 앤 오너 트루 파더. 오퍼링 릴리즈 앤 로즈즈 인 트리뷰트. True Father was born in Cheongju, North Pyongyang Province in now North Korea, on the sixth day of the first lunar month in 1920. He distinguished himself from an early age by his courage, his compassion, and his persistence. Most notable was his thirst to learn from nature. While he was still at school, Sun Myung Moon received the call from heaven to end human suffering. As a young man, our father spoke frequently about God's relationship with us, and about nature and about history. He spoke with conviction about God's will. Worn out Bible in hand, he would go to the mountains and pray in tears. He sought to achieve mastery over himself before seeking dominion over greater things. He worked for the independence of his homeland. At 26 years of age, he went to Pyongyang. He hoped the Christian foundation would stand strong after Korea's liberation from annexation, but instead, a harsh course of suffering and sorrow lay ahead. During the Korean War, True Father completed the original manuscript of the Divine Principle in the city of Busan, and on May 1, 1954, he founded the Holy Spirit Association for the Unification of World Christianity, heralding a new beginning in God's providence. The Unification Principle teaches that human potential is fulfilled through loving relationships. Wherever Father taught, people cried and sang, and a hope for a peaceful world grew. When a wave of intelligent young students surged into the movement, persecution ensued. Dozens of new members were expelled from their schools, and True Father himself was unjustly incarcerated. Following True Parents' holy wedding in 1960, the model for true couples, true parents, and a true family came into being, the basis for a world of peace. There were many trials, but the movement had ambition and high ideals, and began to expand greatly.
One world on the
하나님의 영원 불변 절대의 소원이요 목적이시니 반드시 이루어질 것이나 먼저 종교 통일을 하고야 가능한 것입니다.
Hundreds of global speaking engagements occurred. Wherever Father spoke, the Word of God illuminated a new nation each day. He spoke with an oxygen tank nearby in alpine regions and visited developing nations in those past years when foreign visitors still faced health risks. He spoke to political leaders, scientists, scholars, and religious people, and they welcomed him. His key public speeches amount to more than 330 scripts. The cost of indemnity was high. Four of his children died. True Father also faced death at significant providential junctures, but each time he prevailed. His teachings spread throughout the world, with members active in as many as 194 nations. The global movement is a framework for Chan-il-guk, God's kingdom of love. True Father's efforts to substantiate the vision of one family under God has been driven by the conviction that God's love will change the world. From the late 1960s, True Father's work for interreligious harmony, calling on religious people to cooperate wherever the world faced a crisis. In the Middle East, he encouraged Jews and Muslims to embrace each other. When people feel they are brothers at heart, conflicts visibly reduce.
We hope to see him very soon in the land of peace, in the Terra Santa, in the Holy Land.
True Father established many international organizations, including the Women's Federation and the Universal Peace Federation. He strove to inspire renewal at the United Nations. Weeks before his ascension, he launched the Able Women UN. Scholars around the world were impressed by Father's insight. In 1985, at the height of the Soviet power, he predicted the end of communism. A few short years later, the Berlin Wall came down. Father met Soviet President Mikhail Gorbachev and played a major role in bringing communism to an end as a major world power. This exemplified God's love in practice.
And, oh yes, we won the Cold War.
True Father embraced North Korean leader Kim Il-sung, under whose regime Father had been sent to a labor camp for his religious activities. Will North and South Korea now be able to show the world a model of peace? The Global Age. Schools and universities such as Sun Moon University educate young people to become global citizens who love heaven, love others, and love their countries. The Seige Times, Tiempos del Mundo, and the Washington Times are part of a worldwide media network striving to protect family values and promote the growth of a responsible and free society.
While the Washington Times is alive and well, conservative views will never be drowned out. And if they are heard, they will prevail, as they have in the past.
Father constantly supported the equal distribution of technology and resources. He made significant contributions to Korea's industrial growth through technology transfer at a time when Korea's industries were not well developed. He also predicted as early as 1960s that the oceans would become an important reservoir of resources, and so he set up marine industry bases around the world. Universal Ballet is a recognized ballet company that has performed in major cities. The Little Angels have introduced Korean culture throughout the world. And there's the Peace Cup, where the world becomes one through soccer. through such initiatives, True Father worked to elevate the human spirit and promote peace. Political and social leaders are working with the diverse projects True Father has initiated or inspired. True Father's greatest gift to humankind is the blessing, through which the original sin is forgiven. Men and women from different backgrounds become husband and wife, overcoming nationalism, racism, religious bigotry, and cultural intolerance. These couples are the citizens of a new nation as they raise families with God at their center. True Father's sermons and speeches, given over 60 years, now fill hundreds of volumes. They are an important aspect of his legacy, a treasure for all humanity. His life was expressed in the truth he expounded. His tearful prayers always moved our hearts.
다시 찾고 다시 빚어 만들고 수고하신 하나님 아버지, 이제 역사적인 한스러운 세계는 끝이 났습니다.
He told us how he practiced speaking quickly so he could pass on his teachings more efficiently. Sometimes drenched in sweat, he would speak and pray out of his infinite love for all people. Cheongjong-gung and Hanam-dong in Korea, East Garden and Chunghwa-gung in America, North Garden in Alaska, Jardim in Brazil, all became bases for his global providential work. On January 15th, 2009, at 90 years of age, the year of True Parents' golden wedding anniversary, he offered the crown of glory to God.
Dr. and Mrs. Moon, you are unsurpassed champions of peace, and we invite you to take the position of King and Queen of True Love and Peace.
True Parents work to revive a world wallowing in sin, to liberate all of creation and open the gates to Chunil-guk. After years of demonstrating a heart of devotion towards God, the era after the coming of heaven dawned, and a beginning of a world of lasting peace could be felt. Father began each day with Hundokhi at 5 a.m., and sometimes ended late in the day. Once, he almost spoke for 24 hours without taking a single break. He spent long hours planning the ocean providence. On the open seas, he felt no boundaries between heaven and earth, eating simple food under a broad sky. He sang songs that moved even God, and he drew closer to his children and his disciples through dance, song, and recreation. True Father, since you proclaimed the 13th day of the lunar calendar month in 2013, Foundation Day, you punished your body, which made each day seem as if it were 1,000 years. True Father, you offered your final prayer to God and reported the completion and conclusion of the providence. Did you have to leave us carrying the burden of our sins in order to secure victory on Foundation Day? It's as if the heavens collapsed and the earth has cracked open. Your footprints show the path that all humanity might follow to become devoted sons or daughters, patriots, saints, and ultimately true parents. We firmly believe that the day will come when we will stand as one in God's true love with one heart and one body. On that day, the aspirations of true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind would have been completed.
평화를 사랑하는 천일국 시민 여러분, 이 기적 같은 역사적인 순간을 여러분의 영혼에 각인하십시오.
The Lord of Truth sainthood and kindness, who has opened the gate of Chunhyo-guk, allowing all of us to receive salvation. The King of 10,000 victories, who wants to give rebirth to everyone throughout heaven and earth. The King of Peace, who opened a tranquil reign of peace in an era after the coming of heaven which has no trace of the fall. Our true Father, who gave us true love, true life, and true lineage to open the pathway to a true family. Our love, whom we shall long for until we turn to stone. Our beloved true Father, the times we spent with you were a blessing. We are so happy and we are so grateful. Father, we will love you eternally. We will always love you. And we will carry you in our hearts forever.